Greetings, people. Paul Mucker here. Today, June 4th, 2011, at 9:10 a.m. Eastern Time. Now, people, this is a preview of my upcoming video, right? I'm preparing it now of what really caused the tornadoes in Massachusetts, okay? I got a notice from the first Circuit Court of Appeals, right? Granting George Bush, Barack Obama, and Timothy Geithner, granting them extension of time for filing a brief until July 29th without giving me the opportunity to voice my objection, because they were supposed to file a brief and they didn't file a brief. All 50 governors of all 50 states didn't file a brief. So they're supposed to be in default. But this court gonna give them extension of time to file a brief without even honoring the rules and give me a chance to voice my objection. So I was angry when I read the letter. So I called the clerk office, and you're about to hear my conversation between me and the clerk. And I'm not gonna hide anything from you guys. This is not a private conversation, okay? There's no privacy here. The courts are trying to hide this case from the public. They refuse to give me oral argument. They're trying to hide this case from the public, so I'm going to bring it to the public, okay? So, there's no privacy here. So, if the court, YouTube, if the court trying to make you take down this video, do not listen to them, okay? It's public. This is public knowledge, okay? They had it in the lawsuit, and I'm going to bring it to the public, because they won't even let me in the court. They won't even let me near the courts. I have to be escorted by federal marshals. They won't give me a hearing in the court. Okay, they're hiding from me. It's like they're scared of me. Okay, so since they won't see my face, I'm gonna bring it to you the best way I can. Okay, so I hope the clerk don't mind me doing this, but I have to show you guys what's going on. Okay, so this is the conversation I have with the clerk. And people, I call the clerk office at 3:51 p.m. Eastern Time, as I'm gonna show you all the video I'm making. 3:51 p.m. Eastern Time, I called the clerk office to voice my objection. The conversation lasts about maybe three, almost 4 minutes. I hung up the phone and I did my march around my room. And at 4:05, tornado warning came on. Okay, when I told y'all, when my spirit get angry, my Lord spirit get angry also. It takes a lot to get me angry. I mean, sometimes y'all might think I'm angry. I'm not really over the top, but this one went over the top, okay? So y'all gonna see the reason why tornado struck Massachusetts. Okay, one.
Yep, I got it.
Yeah, my question is, how is it that they would allow to file a motion for extension of time and I haven't even gotten a chance to voice my objection? And how is it that Adam is not in today, but this case... No. But I would like to voice my, because they're in default, so I'm not arguing with you, and I have to record this conversation because I don't want anyone to say I threaten you, because I'm not allowed to come into the court without being escorted by the federal marshal, so I don't want anyone to say I'm making a threat. So I'm asking your permission to record this conversation just for my protection, because I know they're listening to me. They're listening to my conversation. They're spying on me, so I don't want anyone to say, because you guys being very nice to me, especially, that's why I like to speak to Adam, because Adam is very nice to me, and I prefer to speak to him because I know he will never lie and say I threaten him. So the point I'm trying to make is that I would like to voice my objection, because they are in default. They had an order. The order said they have to file a brief, not a motion, not a dispositive motion. That's not the law, the rule. The rule said they have to. They have to file a brief. They waited until the last minute to file. The court, the order say no extension of time is allowed without good cause. They haven't shown any good cause, sir. I know I should be arguing with you. I'm just asking you to give me time to file my objection, because they have not filed. The court, the rule is specific. It says no extension allowed without good cause. So why did you allow them when they haven't shown any good cause? They haven't shown any cause except that they assumed that the court would allow their motion to thwart the case, and they assume wrong. And under the law, sir, under the law, I think you should give me a chance to file my objection before giving them granting this motion, because you granted it to them, and that's not fair. Because the law is the law, sir. The law is the law, and they have to file a brief, not a motion, sir. And if they file a motion, they have to be with good cause. They have not shown any good cause, which means I have a right
to object to this, and I think you should withdraw the order, grant them, and give me the week, 7 days to file a motion to object to this, sir. It's only fair. It's the law.
Why don't you file a motion to reconsider?
Okay, then I'll do that then. Because you understand what I'm saying? They the order was specific. You have to file a brief by May 31st. Not a motion to throw the case, but a brief. And the government is so presumptuous. They think that the court, there's separation of powers. The government cannot assume that the court will rule on their behalf. Because if the court rule on their behalf, then the court is showing that there's no separation of powers. So the court is in error. And I should be able to appeal to the Supreme Court. Because the court, the First Circuit Court is in error. They're trumping the separation of powers. Because the government cannot assume that the court gonna throw out my case because the lower court ruled. Because in the First Circuit Court, it's de novo. They have to look at it de novo. So they cannot be presumptuous. So you see my point?
I do see your point.
So reconsideration, I should file a motion for reconsideration.
That's correct.
Thank you, I appreciate you. That's why I say, I mean, you clerks, you guys are so good to me, and I don't know why they have to escort me to see you guys, because you guys are so nice to me. I mean, wow, without you guys, I'd be lost. You know, so I appreciate you guys, and I don't know why they're trying to escort me to see you guys. I don't understand it, but okay. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Alright, KK, my friend. So people, the clerk told me to file a motion for reconsideration, right? So I felt a little better, you know. So this was, I felt a little better. And then, as if they didn't insult me enough, right? I think the court allowed, the first attorney that had already dropped, right? At 4:40, right? I checked my mail and I got another notice. Okay. This time, the court denied me. See what happened, people? I put a motion for the government to pay for the cost of the lawsuit, to pay for the lawsuit, right? Because I said I can't afford to pay for it without depriving myself. So the court denied me. So I filed a motion for reconsideration, right? And they denied me. So the judges, these judges, right, the wise men, denied me. Said I have to pay $495 if I want to proceed with this case. Are they going to throw it out? Okay? Denying motion for reconsideration of this court. Order denying motion for leave to proceed in forma pauperis. Directing appellant to pay filing fee by 6/13/2011. See, so I have to pay $495 by June 13th. Are they going to throw the case out? Okay? So, after reading this, people, of course I got angry again. And then what happened? The second tornado dropped. Let me call it right back. Right back, 2 seconds. The second tornado dropped. At 6:20 or 6:30. The second tornado dropped. So, the court, the First Circuit Court of Appeals, the federal court, their iniquitous ruling is one of the main reasons why this tornado dropped in Massachusetts. That and what the Attorney General also have done to me. Okay, times for cleansing. Okay, it's a war of attrition. So people, the full length movie gonna be available probably by Sunday or Monday. All right, take care.